Hey guys, welcome back to Amanda's Favorites. Today's video is a little bit different. It is part of a collaboration with 25 other YouTubers called 25 Days of Planner Tips. So I want to welcome anyone who's new here. Thanks for watching. I review lots of planners. I share my own planning journey and style, but I also review as many planners as possible to just try to help you find the planner that you need without spending a lot of money and wasting money. And that is the aim of my channel. I have a lot of different playlists with planners divided up by company, by weeklies, by dailies. So I hope that the way that I've divided up my playlists helps you find what videos you're looking for. I just recently filmed a top 5 weekly for the year and a top 5 daily for the year, just my personal faves. And I will link those videos down below because if you are just getting started in the planner world, that is a great place to start. So today we're going to talk about using printables from these companies, free printables, as a way of trying things out before you spend the money. First of all, I think the first question you need to ask yourself after you watch some videos, get familiar with different planners, is do you want a daily or a weekly planner? That's the first question that comes to my mind after you've familiarized yourself with planners in general. I myself actually utilize a daily and a weekly, and I have done this for several years. So the weekly that I use is Erin Condren Vertical and in the Colorful, and the daily that I use is Simplified by Emily Lay, her daily planner. I have actually utilized the system of using a weekly and a daily planner for several years, like I mentioned. That is because my weekly gives me an overview of my whole week, but I do not have room for all the lists that I need to make in my weekly. So in my weekly, it sits on my kitchen desk and it just stays there as kind of like my guiding light. And anytime I think of something, I can go scribble it in down there, and I plan very far ahead in my planners. I do not sit down and sticker up or plan my planner once a week. Anything like that, I plan far ahead. As my days go, I plan my planner. So there's not just one day that I sit down and plan in my planner. Stuff is already written in months ahead. And I'm not a huge sticker person. That's another thing to look at and ask yourself. So I just use Erin Condren's monthly seasonal sticker book. And that's pretty much all I use in this planner. And I go far ahead and I sticker for the entire year right when I get my planner. And that way my planner is already all stickered for the whole year. I never have to sit down and do anything else with stickers. And that way I can come in and functionally plan as things come up, because I won't be worried about, well, where am I going to put that sticker? So that's how I utilize my weekly. My daily is my right-hand man. It comes upstairs with me, downstairs with me. I am a stay-at-home mom with 2 boys who are 15 and 10 years old. I also run this channel, and I also homeschool my youngest, my 10-year-old. And that keeps me very busy. So my daily planner stays right next to me all day. Upstairs to my office is upstairs. It stays downstairs on the kitchen table with me when I'm working in the kitchen and homeschooling. It is just my running list for the whole day. A lot of times my list spills over into the appointment side when I don't have any appointments that day. Since I homeschool, I try not to schedule a lot of appointments. Friday tries to be like our errand or appointment day. That is how I utilize a daily and a weekly planner together. Many people only use a weekly. Many people only use a daily. This system is just what works for me, and it has for several years. I actually have a whole video about going more into depth on my system, and I actually give planning updates on an updates playlist every quarter. So I will also link those videos down below if you're interested and knowing more about how I plan and seeing how I use a daily and weekly together. I just want to flip through really fast a huge stack of dailies and then a huge stack of weeklies, just showing you there are so many different kinds of planners. And that's why I say after watching some videos and becoming familiar, I would suggest getting on these websites and seeing if they have printables. And we're going to get into that. So this is an Erin Condren daily. It's a small quarterly book. This is an Inkwell Press daily. It is a disc-bound system with Inkwell Press that's new this year for their undated daily pages. Many dailies also come undated, and also weeklies too. This is a She Plans daily, quarterly book. This is my Simplified that I actually use. This is a Kit Life daily planner. This is a Date Designer daily planner. And that is just the tip of the iceberg. I actually have reviews on all of these planners. And if you can't find a certain review you're looking for in the different playlists, definitely hook up with me on Instagram and I will help you find that, or in a YouTube comment. And definitely join me on Instagram at Amanda's Favorites. That's where I do all my giveaways. I just finished 12 days of grateful giveaways and I am giving away a simplified planner in December. I don't know the day yet on that, but that's where I host my giveaways and that is also where I check in every day and really get to know my community well. Here are some weekly planners. Golden Coil, you actually get to pick and design your own planner. And that's what this one is. So it's a weekly, but with a weekly and a list on one side. These are all horizontal weeklies that I've pulled first for you to see. Ashley Shelley, Erin Condren, Refresh by Workspacery, and another horizontal from Inkwell Press. I have a stack of a whole bunch of vertical planners. This is actually a list planner. It's really a different, unique layout. It's called the Spaces Planner. This is a planner I just reviewed, Unbound, and it has gotten rave reviews. It has your weekly vertical layout, but then it also has a two-page spread for every week for list making and habit tracking. And this is a bound book, so that's something else to look at. How small or big do you want your book? Do you want bound? Do you want coil? Get to Workbook is a nice black and white vertical spread. Passion Planner, another vertical spread, black and white only. She Plans quarterly books, another vertical black and white spread. Inkwell Press's vertical spread. Erin Condren's hourly vertical spread. And then Erin Condren's just vertical, not hourly spread. As you can see, with that only being the tip of the iceberg, it is hard to wade through the rabbit hole of the planner world. Today, there are literally thousands of planners out there. Some are online only, some are in-store only, some are both. It is very hard to navigate that world. And that's why I try to review as many as I can for you and really try to organize my playlist so that you will be able to find and navigate what you're looking for in a planner. Many planner websites offer free printables. Some even offer a free PDF for their entire planner, such as Passion Planner. So if you wanted to print your entire own Passion Planner and bind it yourself, you could. They offer free PDFs. You can print them out and they cut down to the exact size that their book is. So this is Passion Planner Pro. And then you can fill it out and use it for a week. You can put it on a clipboard or put it in a notebook or bind it however you want. You can print out several weeks worth. If you're trying to give different systems a try, if you're trying to see, do I want weekly? Do I want daily? Does horizontal work better for me or does vertical work better for me? And that's where the free printables come into play. If you do not see somewhere on a company website, if you can't find their free printables, I recommend emailing the company. Ask them if they have free printables. Sometimes you don't know about that. The Unbound Planner that I just showed you, they actually are offering a free PDF just for December of the entire month of December if you sign up for their newsletter. But that's not something I saw on their website, and that's not something you would know about unless they have told you or maybe they have announced it on Instagram. So I would recommend if you don't see a free printable on the planner website that you're looking at to email the company. It never hurts to ask. They might have something it's not as easy to find on their website, or they might have just a special that they're offering then, like the one that I mentioned with the Unbound Planner. Now, some companies like Simplified Planner gives you a printable of their page, but it is not down to the page size. So you can't quite tell, will that page size work for me? But they just do it on a full-size sheet of paper. I actually love when they do the printables to the exact size of the page and then with dotted lines so you can cut around them. I love that. So this is Passion Planner. This is Simplified Planner Daily. She also offers her weekly in a printable. And then some printables that you may not know about. like Inkwell Press has many free printables if you sign up for her newsletter, and you can also find them on her website, but they come straight to your inbox if you're signed up for her newsletter. Really great printables that can help you in your planning, not necessarily the page layout. Inkwell Press doesn't actually have one of their page layout, and neither does Erin Condren. But in the Erin Condren store, if you actually have one of her stores near you, there are only two stores open in Austin, Texas, and Virginia. I can't remember where. I only know Texas because I'm here in Texas. But in her store, she actually has a free sample book on her writing table that anyone can take one home. That's in the Erin Condren store, and it has every single one of her layouts in there, vertical, hourly, and horizontal. And then you can also test out her paper, which is amazing. I wish they would sell those books on the Erin Condren site because I feel like a lot of people would buy those sample books. So if you have a friend near one of the Erin Condren stores, maybe you can talk them into going in and grabbing you a sample book and mailing it to you. Yeah, I just went and grabbed. This is the Erin Condren sample book that is in their stores, not on her website, but hopefully someday on her website. It is on the writing table that is in her store. You might not even know about it, and you might not even know you could take one home. But it has Erin Condren's handwriting in it. It has the exact paper used in her planner, and then it gives you a vertical colorful layout, a horizontal neutral layout, then her hourly and colorful. It gives you a monthly layout of hers to try out, and these are the exact sizes of her pages. Then she gives you some of her coloring pages, which are in the back of her planners, her lined page, her dot grid page, so you can see if that works for you. And she even just gives you a sample of their contacts page right there. So I feel like this book is indispensable, and I wish all the big planner companies would sell these on their sites, because I feel like if people could try and test their paper, test, you know, writing a schedule out, that it could really help them in choosing a planner. But here are just some productivity tips and some action pages. There's some project pages. So Inkwell Press has a lot of printables. They do not have their planner as a PDF printable, but they do have a lot of free printables you can utilize. Get to Workbook does not have their planner page as a printable, as far as I know, but she has mailed out cool printables like this in her newsletter. So if you sign up for her newsletter, where if you want to chart something for the whole year, like a habit, I love Get to Workbook. Emily Lay has a ton of printables. She has brain dumps of all different kinds, and Plan with Lakin, who is another YouTuber, an awesome YouTuber. She has a blog, and she has made free printables on her blog. This is one of them that actually my littlest sister has utilized and loved using. So you never know where you can find those free printables. Like I said, definitely ask the companies for them. It only takes a minute to email those companies and see if they have a free printable available for you to try. And it can save you a lot of money. If you just plan in a planner for a week or two, I promise you absolutely just know if that planner clicks with you or if it doesn't. And when you're just first jumping into the rabbit hole of the planner world, you just have to figure out if you need a daily only, if you need a weekly only, if you need a combination and a daily and a weekly. Maybe you need a planner just for work that stays at your office. And then you need a home planner also for your personal life. That's what my littlest sister does. So you have to just figure out what works for you. And that will change as the seasons in your life change, as it has for me. But those are some of the first questions you can ask yourself, and definitely utilize the free printables. And everyone, let's just write to Erin Condren and get them to sell this book on their website, because I think it's genius to be able to try out every single spread and her paper. Who wouldn't pay, you know, five or I don't know how much it would cost to manufacture and mail them out, $5 or $8 for this book, and to be able to try out those layouts. And make sure to check out the link down in my description box for the next 25 Days of Planner Tips gal. It's Kristen Morgan from The Gold Project. It's tomorrow, December 12th, and she will be linked down in my description box below. So make sure to check out her planner tip tomorrow for our 25 Days of Planner Tips. All right, guys, thanks for joining me. Happy planning, and we'll see you next time.